Enable subtitle. Hello everyone, in this video we will learn how to get offsets from memory addresses gamma guardian values for a mod menu. Before starting, note that this tutorial uses AIDE Pro on PC and Offset Tester VIP. If you don't have both, this guide won't be useful. First, get the latest offset tester from Aadil Mods Netlify app. This time we will mod Hill Climb Racing. But first, let's install Offset Tester. It supports root mode, but since not everyone has root access, we'll inject it into the game. The injection process is the same as a normal LGL mod menu. Open the classes, dex file and add the code below the game's main activity on create. You can copy the code directly from Offset Tester. This error appears if the class's dex size has reached its limit. In that case, we need to redivide the dex. I think this requires MT Manager VIP, but if you don't have it, you can use alternatives like modded MT or NP Manager. Now you can follow the same process as before, but this time you won't get any errors. Add the offset tester dex and lib into the game. Since the game already has 6 dex files, rename the offset tester dex to classes 7 before adding it. Now add both the lib and dex. Open the Android manifest, and if extract native libs is set to false, change it to true. If extract native libs is not there, you don't need to change anything. Since I want to make the mod for ARM8, I will remove the ARM7 libraries, but even if you don't, a 64-bit phone will use ARM8 by default. Anyway, just install the game. Now open the game. As you can see, Offset Tester has been successfully implemented into the game. We will use the memory tracer in Offset Tester, which is a premium feature, so you need an active subscription. By default, the library is set to libil to cp, but Hill Climb Racing is not a Unity game, so its main library is libgame.so. Now open Gamma Guardian. Since it requires root, you can use an emulator or apps like Vomos or Vafanagaga if your device is not rooted. Now click the Gamma Guardian icon and select the game process. First, we will mod coins, search for the coin value. Currently, I have 18,895 coins, so I will search that. There are many results, so we need to refine the search. I spent some coins, and now I have 14,895, so I'll refine the search with the new value. Now I have only 2 results, so no further refining is needed. If you still have more, keep refining until you get 1 or very few results. Since I have 2 results, I'll change the value to see which one is correct. It seems the first address is read-only because I couldn't change its value. But when I change the second address, the value updates and our coins change, which means the second address is correct. We will remove the first address since it is not useful. For the second address, long press it and select copy address. Now in Offset Tester, go to display values and then static values. In Memory Tracer, paste the coin address. For the trace repeat, it is recommended to enter small values like 3, 5, or 10. Now, click Show Captured Traces and start tracing. Since we selected write-only mode, spend some coins so the coin value gets written. We have 2 unique offsets, but we will trace more to get more offsets. Also, switch to read mode to capture read offsets as well. Now we have 6 unique offsets, which should be enough. Long press the box to copy its text. paste it into Notepad. Now, let's find the offsets for fuel as well. Unlike coins, we don't know the exact value of fuel. Normally, fuel and similar values are percentage-based, with a maximum of 100 and a minimum of 0. Since we currently have about 75% fuel, I'll search for less than 90%. Also, values like fuel and speed are usually float data types, so we will select float and click on New Search. Since our fuel is more than 50%, we will refine the search with that logic too. We still have more than a million results. Since our fuel keeps decreasing, in GG we will keep refining with value decreased. Repeat the process until you get very few results. Okay, now we have only one result. Let's edit it to confirm if it's correct. So it's confirmed that this is the correct address. Now copy the address, and we will follow the same steps as we did for coins. Clear previous traces, add the new address, and start tracing. This time we got 3 offsets for fuel. We will paste these into Notepad as well. Now we need to use a PC, and I'll transfer the copied text there. You need to open the library in AIDE Pro. Since it takes time to load, I have already done it. You can also see that I have transferred the copied text. Every offset is useful, but we'll use the ones that are easiest to implement in our mod menu. Anyway, just copy the first offset. You need to jump to that offset in AIDE Pro, press G or right-click the offset and select Jump to Offset. AIDE Pro has an option to view pseudocode, which we will use. The shortcut key is F5, or you can go to View Subview Pseudocode. Also, in the IDEA view, right-click the offset and sync IDEA view with pseudocode. By looking at the pseudocode, I can see that the offset points to a static address. However, it also has an is equal to 23 condition. I'm not sure why this exists for coins, and since we have 6 offsets, we can skip it and try another one. We just repeat the same steps. This one also looks difficult, so let's skip it as well. Now, let's try the third offset. This one is easy to understand. The function takes a new value as input and adds it to the existing coins. It's stored in dword address, and since dword means int, I think it's the direct static address for coins. Anyway, we can't be sure without testing, so we'll use offset tester to check. Go to display single values. I usually get the values in offset tester before modding, which is why we use get values. Anyway, now go to direct memory instance. We enter 0 so that offset tester uses the library base address. You can see the address in the box matches the library address. Anyway, now go to the int tab and enter that static address there. It shows the current coin value, which means the address is correct. Now we will go to the set void or field section and modify the coin value. We need to repeat the same process here. But instead of getting the value, this time we will set a new value. As you can see, it's working. I can set it to any value I want. I am noting down the address in Notepad. I will show how to use it in the mod menu later in the video. Now we will mod fuel. Same as before, we go to the offset in AIDE Pro and check which function is easy to understand. This one looks easy, but let's check the others too in case they are even easier. This one looks difficult, so let's skip it. The second and third offsets are from the same function, and it looks difficult, so we'll use the first offset. From the pseudocode, a 1 is the instance, and it looks like a 1 plus 1356 is the fuel. and the hex value of 1356 is 0x5 for C. Let's test it. The sub offset is the update offset, which gives us the instance. And 5 for C is the field for fuel, since 1356 in hex is 5 for C. Wait, we're getting 0. We should be getting the fuel value, which is around 90%. This means we did something wrong, or the offset or field isn't correct. But it's very unlikely that offset tester's memory tracer gives a wrong offset, so I think the field is the problem. Now we will find the fuel address again and compare it with the offset tester instance address. I'm speeding up the video since I've already shown how to find the address. This is the current fuel address. Copy the address from the box. Save the fuel address. In Gamma Guardian, go to the address we copied. The first 6 letters of the address are unnecessary, so we'll remove them. Anyway, save this address too. Here, only 2 addresses will show, so don't worry if you see 2 instead of 3 like in the video. Select the 2 addresses and check the difference. So 5D4 is the real field. Last time when I modded this game, the 5D4 field was visible directly in AIDE Pro. I don't know why it didn't show this time, but as a modder you need to figure out what to do in such cases. Anyway, we are now getting the fuel value after using 5D4. Now we will use this offset in set void or field to modify the fuel. But first, we need to unhook the offset, because we can't hook the same offset multiple times. Now, in the set void or field section, enter the offset, the field, and the new fuel value. As you can see, it's working. Note the offset and field in Notepad. Next, I'll show how to hook them. First, we will add an input value to set coins. We need the library base inside the switch cases, so we'll declare libbase as a global variable. Let's assign the input value to feetNum10. Since the coin's address is static, we modify it like this. Done, now whenever you enter a new value, the coins will be set to it. Let's write the hook for fuel. We'll use a toggle for it. The hook for fuel is pretty simple, it's just a normal field hook. By the way, I'm using LGL Mod Menu version 4.0. The field is 5D4. If unlimited fuel is enabled, the fuel will be set to 100%. Let's write the case and declare the variable. Also, remove any unnecessary code. Replace the offset. Don't forget to change the library name. Now just compile the mod menu, add it to the game, and it will work. That's it for today's video. If you have any questions or issues,